Dear guys, today we are going to learn about the reflection part 3. In the previous video, I have taught you about what is mirror, and now some terms which are connected with mirror we are going to study in this new video. So the terms connected with mirror, the followings are the basic terms which are connected with mirror. Now what are they? And to before going to know this, we have to understand the diagram of the mirror. As it is drawn here, it is a sphere as shown, where C is the center, okay, this sphere, and this X and Y, this is the part of the mirror, and it is obviously a concave mirror. Got it? Now, the terms which are connected with mirror are the C, that is the center of the curvature, the P, the pole of the mirror, F, the principal focus, small f, the focal length, capital R, the radius of curvature, XY, the aperture of the mirror. So these are some of the basic terms which are connected with mirror. Now let us elaborate all these things. So first of all, center of curvature. As you know, it is initially denoted by capital C. Center of curvature. It is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. Okay. Now it is denoted by capital C. It is the center of the sphere, this sphere, of which the mirror is only a part of that sphere. Got it? Now it is called center of curvature. Now comes pole, which is denoted by capital P. The pole. It is the midpoint of the reflecting surface of the mirror. This is the reflecting surface of the mirror, and it is the midpoint. X to P will be equal to P to Y. So it is the midpoint of the reflecting surface of the mirror. Now, principal axis. It is one of the important term. Now, it is an imaginary straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of the mirror. This straight line which passes through the center of curvature and pole of the mirror is called the principal axis. Okay. Now the principal focus. This one, principal focus. This term, this point. It is a point on the principal axis such that the rays after reflection either pass through or appears to come from. It is a point on the principal axis through which if it is a concave mirror, then rays parallel coming to the principal axis after reflection will pass through this point, or if it is a convex mirror, then the rays coming parallel to the principal axis after reflection will appear to come from the principal focus. So such the name. Now comes the focal length, small f. It is the distance measured from the pole of the pole to the principal focus. From pole to the principal focus, this length, straight line distance, is called the focal length of the mirror. Similarly, the radius of curvature, capital R, this one, it is the distance measured from the pole of the mirror to the center of curvature. Also, we can define it, it is the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. So, it is another definition of radius of curvature. Got it? This one is the concept. Now, finally, the aperture of the mirror, which is denoted here only by XY. It is the diameter of the reflecting surface of the mirror. Again, I am saying that it is the diameter of the reflecting surface of the mirror. This one. It is the reflecting surface of the mirror. Now, suppose suppose this one is the mirror, and this is the polished surface, and this is the reflecting surface. So, this diameter, this one, these two points, a straight line joining from the reflecting surface from here to here will be called as the aperture of the mirror, or it is simply known as the linear aperture of the mirror. If it is the reflecting surface, then this distance will be called as the linear aperture or simply aperture. And if it is the reflecting surface, then this distance will be called as the linear aperture or aperture of the mirror. Okay, thank you all.